Shake a leg. You need to get inside Buckingham Palace. It's your best hope for weapons and supplies, even if it is overrun by infected. careful. Radio signal won't reach you down there. You're on your own. Lovely woman, the Queen. For an ancient lizard posing as a human, anyway. But I tell you, she knows the score. It's the government didn't want anyone to know about Dee's prophecy, not her Madge. I hope they get her away to India or something. Their climate's better for reptiles, anyway. There's your way in. Be careful. I won't have eyes on you down there. You're on your own. I'm losing you. Must be shielded. Watch your back.
How did you get in here? Oh, never mind. You're clean, aren't you? So you must be pretty good. Well, perhaps we could help each other. Sorry, I should explain. There are security monitors and speakers in the walls. I'm Peter Knight, junior doctor to the royal household. So don't worry, you're not going mad. Do come and find me in the lab, won't you?
Yes. Shame about this chap. He couldn't handle the horror, you see. Then again, maybe he was more sensible than the rest of us. Sorry, I know these corridors are a labyrinth. But well, that's the point, you see, to keep intruders out. I suppose I should warn you, there are also a few infected roaming around in here. Used to be Omega Group soldiers, you see, but... well, they're all infected now. Terrible shame. Do make yourself at home. But please, don't touch anything. This is all vital scientific work. I'll close the door behind you, just a precaution. Sorry, I can't greet you in person. It's safer for both of us, you understand? for this terrible infection. You see, it's slow going, as I have so few subjects to test on. Like those poor Omega Group soldiers. Not my finest hour, I fear. If you'll forgive me for a moment, I'm sure you can help me. I say, steady on, old girl. Right. Now here's how you could help. There's a book, De Remedi Secreti, by Conrad Gesner. A fascinating text, but what I'm after is Dee's own copy where he made annotations. I believe it's in the palace library, which means going upstairs, I'm afraid. Would you be so kind? The bunker elevator can take you up to the palace. I hope you don't mind the music, by the way. William Byrd, Elizabeth I's favorite composer, apparently. I find it helps me work, it's very soothing. You're doing ever so well. I do feel awful about the poor guards. Well, technically, I'm an Omega Group myself. Started as an army medic, and then they posted me here. That's such a shame. Those soldiers were elite. So sad to see them like this.
The angel chided me thus. Ignorance was the nakedness whereby you first were tormented. Ignorance was the nakedness whereby you first were tormented. And the first plague that fell upon man was the wanting of science. The want of science hinders you from knowledge of your own self. The angel chided me thus. Ignorance was the naked.
I've just realized you probably have no idea what Omega Group is. Top secret, you see, but well, that hardly matters now. It's an elite group to protect the royal family. But the outbreak caught us on the hop, and now all these poor men who used to guard the bunker... Well, I suppose you could say they're still guarding it. If only we'd paid more attention to Dr. D.
Hey!
Patients succumb immediately to infection in the region where the malady enters the body. Violent convulsions follow, and their veins turn black as ink. Poisoned blood radiates from the wound, spreading like the roots of a venomous tree, accelerated by unnatural haste. It would be beautiful, if not for its dark design.
Back again? No luck finding the Gesner book upstairs, I see. Well, sorry, but I must return to my work. Do help yourself to anything you need, won't you?
That you can definitely use, especially in this bloody place. Nice and quiet.
In some subjects, pockets filled with a rich, acrid pus form near... The patient must be restrained and cannot be calmed by any manner of herbal sedative. She seems ravenous, and nothing I feed her can satiate her monstrous appetite. As if compelled by a most foul instinct to devour all...
Where was I? You must forgive me. I'm a little distracted. Ah, yes, Dr. D. John D. was a scientist, alchemist, natural philosopher and all that, to Elizabeth I. Some people say he was even a spy. Imagine that. And D wrote a warning, you see, about this outbreak. Oh, dear. Sorry, must dash. Hello. Oh, I see you found Gesner's book. I do hope it wasn't too much trouble. Pass it through, would you? Wait. There's something else. That gadget of yours looks rather like something the Omega chaps used to carry. Would you step over there and scan that infected chap with it?
A full scan and analyze, mind you, to isolate the infected gland. The human body really is a fascinating thing. Even after all vital signs in the subject cease, the body continues to fight the infection. Amazing, eh? I thought so. You'll have to put him out of his misery first. Then take the syringe and fill it up with antibodies from the infected gland. Perfect. Now, that syringe will synthesize a viricide, a sort of poison, quite deadly. There's enough for one injection, but you can refill it from another willing volunteer. In return, I need another favor. A second book, Studium Contagione, a study of infection by Dee himself. It's very rare, but I happen to know Ron Friedman has a copy in his flat on Brick Lane. Ron's one of those Raven chaps, you see.
At the end of the day, who lives and who dies comes down to one thing. Preparation. Research your surroundings, scavenge for supplies, stock up your safe house, and do whatever it takes.